using startup repair in Windows 10 and 11. Hi everyone, Leo Notenboom here for askleo.com. Startup repair is a little known underutilized tool that can sometimes get you out of a sticky situation when your machine won't boot. So if your machine can't boot for some reason, startup repair actually is one of the first places I suggest you look. Now you can get to startup repair one of three different ways. You can boot from a recovery drive that you have created yourself already. I believe a recovery drive created on a separate machine, a second machine that's not having a problem, will work. Or you can boot from Windows installation media, which is basically easy to download from Microsoft. And yeah, it includes these recovery tools. The third option actually doesn't really help, because that option is to go through the settings app and the update path, and there you can find a recovery set of tools and such. The problem, of course, is that's chicken and egg. That assumes the machine is running. And by definition, well, we've got a machine that's not. It won't boot. So that third one is useful for perhaps other things, but what we're going to focus on today is booting from different media. The media that I'm going to choose in this example is a Windows 11 setup disk, an actual full Windows 11 installation media. And I'm using Windows 11 here. The process for both Windows 11 and Windows 10 is extremely similar, so this should work actually for both of you. So the very first thing we're going to do is reboot our machine. We will boot from the CD or DVD. Now, if you've done a Windows setup before, this will actually look fairly familiar to you. The very first thing we have to do is tell it what language we're talking, what keyboard we're using. Time and currency, honestly, doesn't really matter that much for this, but that we do have to specify. Then we say next. Do not click on the Install Now button. Do not. That's going to reinstall Windows, and that is not what we want, at least not yet. Instead, what we're going to click on is Repair Your Computer. We're now given several different options. We can continue, which basically bypasses what we just did. We could turn off the PC. We can use a device, ideally boot from something else, but since we've already booted from our installation disk, that's not what we need. What we really do need is something like troubleshooting. And there it is, right at the top, Startup Repair. Click on Startup Repair. Choose a target operating system. Most of the time, you're only going to see one. If you've got multi-boot of some sort, which I believe can happen if you've got some of your backup software installed on the hard drive in a particular way, if you're doing multi-boot with other operating systems, you may see other things here. Most of the time, you won't. And it's just your installation of Windows that we want to repair. It goes into the diagnosing mode. Now, in my case, my machine, there's nothing wrong. And in fact, what's going to happen here is that the startup repair will finish and tell me that, hey, we couldn't repair your PC. Well, yeah, there was nothing to fix. However, sometimes you will find that this point will tell you, hey, yeah, we fixed something. Reboot and see if startup works for you. If it doesn't, you can actually do this multiple times without harm until you finally get to either a working machine or this message that even though your machine is still not booting, startup repair couldn't fix it. At which point you go on to other diagnostic techniques that are beyond the scope of what I want to talk about in this video. We're focusing purely on startup repair simply because it's quick, it's easy, and it actually does solve problems many times. So we're going to go ahead and hit advanced options again, which brings us back to this set of choices. And now we're going to go ahead and continue to Windows 11. I'm not going to press any key to boot from CD. I want to boot from my machine's internal hard drive. And poof, we're back in Windows 11. There we are. That's startup repair. I recommend giving it a try whenever you run into a startup-related problem. If it doesn't fix anything, yeah, it's not going to fix everything. but there are a lot of simple problems that it can resolve, and it's so useful and so quick that it's a very easy thing to try first. For updates, for comments, for links related to this topic and more, visit askleo.com/171782. I'm Leo Notenboom, and this is askleo.com. Thanks for watching.